Thomas Nelson was born into a very wealthy family in York, Virginia. Educated in England and returned home to serve in the Virginia House of Burgesses. The Nelson family fortune was made by Thomas Nelson's grandfather, Scotch Tom, a merchant who had the first customs house in the colonies. Thomas's father, William, then added to the family fortune as a merchant and planter. Thomas Nelson received his basic education in the colonies. When he was 14, he went to England to study at Hackney School. 5 years later, he continued his education at Trinity College in Cambridge. In 1761, Nelson completed his degree at Cambridge and headed back to the colonies. Before his ship reached Virginia, he was elected to the House of Burgesses. His father had made the family's name well known in Virginia, serving as president, judge of the general court, president of the council, and acting governor of Virginia. A year later, Thomas Nelson married Lucy Grimes. As a wedding present, his father gave the new couple a big house located near the family mansion. For the next few years, the young Nelson family entertained friends and lived the life of a rich country family. They kept hounds so that Nelson could take his friends fox hunting twice a week. Nelson was a member of the Virginia Convention, where he submitted a resolution to organize a militia and drafted the Virginia Resolution for Independence. Around 1774, the loyalties of the Virginia colonists began to change. Nelson began to disagree with some of the policies of King George III. Lord Dunmore, the royal governor, dissolved the House of Burgesses, which caused Nelson and 89 other men to gather at the Raleigh Tavern in Williamsburg to protest. In the Raleigh Tavern meeting, they called for a provincial congress to take the place of the House of Burgesses in handling the affairs of the colony. The provincial congress, called the Virginia Convention, met in August of 1774 and selected 7 delegates to attend the Continental Congress. In March of 1775, the convention met for a second time in Richmond in an old church. In Richmond, many people expressed strong feelings about the revolution. In a speech, Patrick Henry said, "The war has actually begun. The next gale that sweeps from the north will bring to our ears the clash of resounding arms. Why stand we here idle? Is life so dear or peace so sweet as to be purchased at the price of chains and slavery? Forbid it, Almighty God. I know not what course others may take, but as for me, give me liberty or give me death." 1 month later, Paul Revere was riding, and the first battles took place at Lexington and Concord. Following Patrick Henry's speech, Thomas Nelson introduced a resolution proposing that Virginia establish its own militia. The debate on Nelson's proposal was long and heated, but the convention ultimately decided to take the step toward independence. A month later, in April 1775, some Virginia loyalists and Governor Dunmore took the munitions, causing a major crisis. Convinced that Lord Dunmore would eventually settle with the colonists, Nelson protected Lord Dunmore from Patrick Henry's troops. A few days later, British troops threatened the Secretary of the Executive Council, who was Nelson's uncle. The British also sent a letter threatening to fire on Yorktown if Lord Dunmore was injured. Both events angered Nelson, who proclaimed from the floor of the House of Burgesses, "I am a merchant of Yorktown, but I am a Virginian first. Let my trade perish. I call God to witness that if any British troops are landed in the county of York, of which I am lieutenant, I will wait no orders, but will summon the militia and drive the invaders into the sea." In July of 1775, the Virginia Convention met and appointed Patrick Henry colonel of the 1st Virginia Regiment and Nelson colonel of the 2nd. A few weeks later, the Virginia Convention elected Thomas Nelson and George Wythe to replace George Washington and Patrick Henry in the Continental Congress. John Adams described Nelson as a fat man. He is a speaker, and alert and lively for his weight. Dr. Rush went on to comment, "A respectable country gentleman, with excellent disposition in public and private life. He informed me that he was the only person out of 9 or 10 Virginians that was sent with him to England for education, that had taken part in the American Revolution. The rest were all Tories." In 1776, Thomas Nelson wrote to John Page about the British, saying, that it was incredible to believe that Americans had any affection for people who are carrying on the most savage war against us. He went on to ask what his constituents felt upon the grand points of Confederation and foreign alliance, or in other words, independence. He continued, "Would you think that we have some among us who still expect honorable proposals from the British administration?" In May of 1776, the Virginia Convention deprived the king of his remaining authority in Virginia by dissolving the Virginia Assembly. A week later, Thomas Nelson presented a resolution for independence to the convention. It was passed. The Virginia Convention sent Thomas Nelson to Philadelphia to deliver the decision to the Continental Congress. When he arrived, his resolution was rewritten by Richard Henry Lee, calling for all the colonies to collectively declare their independence. After Nelson presented the case for independence, Edmund Randolph said that Nelson didn't seem to have any fears and didn't understand the fears of others. Thomas Nelson was 38 years old when he signed the Declaration of Independence. The following May, poor health forced him to resign from the Congress and return to Virginia. Nelson recovered somewhat to become general of Virginia's army and later governor of the state. In August of 1777, Virginia was concerned that the British fleet might invade. Nelson was appointed brigadier general and commander-in-chief of the Virginia militia. The next spring, Congress requested that men of wealth organize troops. Nelson put together an army of about 70 soldiers, which he trained and led to Philadelphia. Not needed, they returned to Virginia the next month. During the war, Nelson served in Congress for a short time, but his financial support was significant. In 1780, $2 million was needed in the treasury to finance the French fleet. Nelson raised the funds by backing the loans himself. As a result, he lost a lot of money when the government could not repay him. In another incident, two regiments would not go south until they were paid. Thomas Nelson paid them. At the siege of Yorktown in 1781, Nelson helped George Washington organize the defense and participated in the battle. Nelson ordered his men to open fire on his own mansion after he discovered that the British had made it their headquarters. Finally, in October, Cornwallis surrendered. Around 1781, Colonel Tarleton, who was the commander of the British troops, tried to find out when and where the legislature would meet in order to kidnap some of the members. The legislature started holding irregular meetings, but the British often located them. Unable to meet regularly, they gave nearly total control of the state government to Nelson and his council. Because the council was dispersed throughout the colony, Nelson was left almost completely in charge of the state government and the militia. In poor health, he improved defenses and kept the government functioning. In November of 1781, after the Battle of Yorktown, Nelson retired as governor because of poor health. Benjamin Harrison, a fellow signer, became acting governor. Thomas Nelson went to live at Offley Hoo, a small house willed to him by his father in Hanover County. Because he had lost most of his money to financing the revolution, he was forced to live the rest of his years rather modestly. He died in 1789 at the age of 50.